And what's up, everyone? Welcome back to the Daily Pfav. This is episode 70 for Wednesday, June 6, 2018. The time is now 9:20 p.m. here on the East Coast. And I actually received some pretty cool feedback today from yesterday's episode where I was talking about getting ready and preparing for hurricane season and some steps and things that you can do to kind of get your house ready and yourself ready in the event that some kind of a storm or event impacts you and your home and your family. And so I upload these podcasts, obviously, everywhere. And you guys know that, Spreaker, iTunes, Google Play, iHeart Radio. But a couple weeks ago, I started also uploading them to YouTube, because why would I not upload them to my YouTube channel as well? YouTube's one of the biggest search engines there is in the world, so all my podcasts are also on YouTube, but I generally don't publicize that too much. But anyway, so someone actually listened yesterday on YouTube and left me a comment and some feedback and said, great episode, would love to hear some more detailed advice on how to get ready and prep for, you know, a storm, or prep a home or an apartment, and how to get myself ready in case, you know, something like this happens. And so a number of years ago, this is, oh my God, I don't even remember what year it was. This is back when, you guys remember when the world was supposed to end, the Mayan calendar thing. I forget what year that was, if it was 2011 or 2012 or something like that. But I actually did an interview for the newspaper. They contacted me and had asked me to talk about, you know, preparing and getting ready and what should families do and what should people do. And so my number one biggest thing that I believe and my biggest tip that I could share to anybody is you have to look at your daily routine. Whatever that daily routine is, whether you are a single person and you live alone, or whether or not you have a family of four, you have to just take a snapshot of your daily routine and start right there and say, if my entire infrastructure is disrupted because of a power outage, because of a storm, flooding, can't get out, can't do this, you know, whatever that is, what are the things that I can have at home to restore myself and my family back to its daily routine? Because one of the biggest things that people have to overcome when a natural disaster happens isn't the actual disaster itself. It's the mental aspect of how it disrupts your daily routine. And people will adapt to that, each according to your own gifts, however you do. Some people will be able to adapt and be able to get through that. Other people won't know where to begin and where to start, and that will further complicate it and make it more difficult for them. So if you are serious about doing any sort of preparation in your own home, you have to start with that number one tip from me. And that is, look at your daily routine and think, as you're sitting in your apartment in your home, shut off all your lights, shut off all your power, and say, okay, what do I need for the next 24 hours to either help me physically, nutritionally, and mentally? And that's where you begin. Again, if you're one of those people that you rely on your cell phone for everything, then you probably need to have a handful or so of those Mophie or any of the other types of cell phone backup batteries that you can keep charged. Obviously, you need flashlights. Obviously, you need batteries. Obviously, you need food. Some people have grills. Some people have propane grills, charcoal grills, whatever you have. Yes, you can still cook. That would be the great time to get to your freezer and start cooking some of that perishable stuff, because again, without power, it will go bad. Now, I know for me, I have a 50-pound bag of gas station ice, you know, those big bags you buy at the gas station, that's in my big freezer in my basement. And it's not because I keep that to use it. It's because I keep that in case I lose power. That will still provide some element of cooling to everything in there and not let it defrost as fast as if it was just unplugged. And you can do that same thing for your upstairs refrigerator. You know, pack every dead space you can with small bags of ice and stuff like that. That really helps keeping your food from going bad. But you've got to start there. You've got to look at your daily routine and say, what are the things I can do? You know, if you're someone that still relies on your computer, okay, well, they sell computer backup batteries that you can charge, and then you'll have computer power. If you're someone that needs the internet and you can't survive 24 hours without the internet, then you better get yourself one of those little MiFi devices. So many things you can do that can mentally get you in the right frame of mind to be able to start thinking straight and be able to put you on a path until life is restored back to normal again. And again, we're not talking about hurricanes or tornadoes. This could just be a 24-hour power outage, 48-hour power outage, something, you know, something small to the extreme. And I talked about the extreme yesterday with having extra food and extra water. But again, we have to think about preparing from small to large, whatever you can afford and whatever you can do. But again, the good rule of thumb on where to start, and I realize online there are thousands of websites, you know, ready.gov has all kinds of family plans and checklists, and they're great. But, you know, more specific to you, you have to look at a snapshot of what your daily routine is in a 24-hour period and think to yourself, if I lost power, if I lost cable, if I lost, you know, everything, you know, what do I need to help me for the next 24 hours to get me back to what I'm used to? Obviously, we're not talking about, you know, catastrophic flooding where you have to abandon your home and evacuate your home or your community or even your region. We're talking about you got to start with the small prepping and the preparedness to get ready for the larger stuff. And then, you know, once you get kind of good at it and you have a system in place, then, you know, you'll be able to start, you know, getting ready and preparing for larger scale incidents that can happen. But those are my number one tips. That's how I did it. That's what started me to get ready. And again, you know, like I said, I feel pretty confident that, you know, if we're not talking about evacuating, you know, if I had to stay in my home without power and without, you know, all of the comforts that I'm used to, I feel pretty much 100% confident that I can get through anything that would happen until, you know, life is restored back to normal. And again, it takes time and it takes money and it takes strategy and it takes some thought. But again, you can get there if you just, you know, slow down for a minute and stop and think, what is it you're trying to accomplish? You know, and again, you can't forget your pets. You can't forget your kids because, you know, if you have a family and you have children, that's the last thing that you need is now having children that now have anxiety because there isn't power, there isn't air conditioning, all the popsicles defrosted, whatever that may be. You need to be able to have things that can help get their mind, you know, off of what's happening and back to being a kid. You know, so again, those are my tips. Like I said, if you guys need more on this, you know, I'm not trying to, you know, write a book or claiming to be an expert on this. But again, you know, this is one of the things that I do. It's one of the things I specialize in through emergency management. And, you know, like I said, that's my number one tip that I have not read anywhere on any website yet, is about the mental aspect of dealing with and overcoming, you know, any kind of incident that disrupts your daily routine. So anyways, I hope that helps. And again, if you, you know, jump online, you can find all this info. It's all there. You can find it anywhere. But I'm going to end it right there for tonight. Paul Falavolito, podcast.com, 412-701-4323. Thanks for listening, and I'll talk to you guys tomorrow.